Tonight in 7 News, the Premier promising big steps out of lockdown. 12 new COVID cases, the 5-kilometre rule challenged, the Premier facing a vote of no confidence, but he says important relief will be announced on Sunday. Also, bikie boss Toby Mitchell arrested over a violent confrontation in South Yarra. An emergency warning for residents in Brunswick as a factory goes up in flames. The Pope sends a message to the world on George Pell. And the AFL booming in Queensland as it heads into the prelim finals.
Live from Melbourne, 7 News with Peter Mitchell starts now.
Good evening. The Premier is promising us big steps out of lockdown to be revealed on Sunday as he faces a backlash over the 5-kilometre rule and a vote of no confidence. He pledged relief as Victoria recorded another 12 COVID cases. That's less than New South Wales, where restrictions are already being wound back even further.
A stubborn day for new cases in locked down Melbourne. 12 here compared to 13 in New South Wales, where restrictions, already much looser than ours, relax even more on Friday. But our chief health officer says it's not a fair comparison.
We are coming down from 725 cases per day down to our 10 to 15 cases per day. We are not building up from a trickle of a small number of cases.
Victoria recorded another death, a man in his 70s. Our rolling average is going the wrong way. It's now 10. But the good news is all but one of today's cases are thought to be linked to known outbreaks. Health officials suspect the 12th is a false positive, meaning there are zero mystery cases today, now seen as the most crucial number in plans to reopen.
Now is the time to start changing a little bit. So more testing of asymptomatics.
Despite our stubborn tail, some restrictions will ease Sunday.
Sunday, we're going to take some big and important steps. Are they everything we'd like to do? No. Will we get there? Yes.
The Federal Treasurer wants restrictions, including the ban on travel outside Melbourne, lifted.
This Sunday is the Premier's opportunity to give millions of Victorians their freedom back.
7 more cases are linked to the Box Hill hospital cluster. Our chief health officer has defended the response to other recent outbreaks. Testing for people without symptoms was ordered in Kilmore, but not Chadstone. That cluster grew to 35 today. Another Chadstone shopper picking up the virus.
Testing every single asymptomatic person who goes to a particular setting when there are tens of thousands of people coming on a daily basis is not value for money and is not necessarily a proportionate approach.
The opposition wants the 5-kilometre travel rule axed immediately, introducing an amendment into the upper house.
I'm trying to say that the 5K rule is not based on science. It was likely made up in the Premier's office.
Even one of the experts who did the roadmap modelling says it should go, but Professor Sutton is wary.
When you double that radius, you're multiplying by 4 times the number of households that you can potentially come into contact with.
We've heard the World Health Organization warn against too many lockdowns, instead saying test, test, test. And that is particularly true tonight. We've recorded our lowest testing figures in 2 weeks, just over 8,000 tests completed. Drive-through test centres like the one here at the showgrounds are open first thing tomorrow. Otherwise, your GP can help. Pete?
Blake Johnson at Ascot Vale, thank you. Daniel Andrews is facing a motion of no confidence in Parliament, with the opposition accusing him of overseeing one of the worst scandals in our state's history. But the Premier wasn't there to witness the motion, dismissing it as a cheap political stunt.
The message on the protest bus outside Parliament was clear and echoed inside the chamber.
Because of these extraordinary circumstances, because of the urgent need for change, and because of the immeasurable damage that the Andrews Labor government is doing to the state that I love, I move this motion of no confidence today.
But as the opposition piled on,
this government has let this state down like no other government has done before.
Daniel Andrews wasn't there to hear a word of it, leaving his deputy to mount the defence.
I rise to oppose the deeply cynical politics in the middle of a pandemic.
The Premier was in the chamber for question time.
If only the shouting of the Leader of the Opposition had any impact on this virus.
He's a man of aerosol, does nothing.
but promptly left before debate began.
It's all about them. It's all about their benefit, not the Victorian community's benefit. It's all about politics.
This is a government that's all focused on themselves, on the cover-ups, on the lies, on the deception.
The motion of no confidence doomed to fail given Labor dominates the lower house and there's no support from the Greens, unimpressed with the opposition's stunts.
We're seeing the rise of Trump-style politics being used by the Liberals, and I'd say to them, they need to seriously pull their head in if they want to be taken seriously.
Sharnel Vella joins us now. And Sharnel, it's set to be a long night on Spring Street.
Well, the no-confidence debate began just before 2 o'clock, but it could be some time before we get an official vote. Some MPs have been given up to an hour to make their arguments, and that means Parliament could be sitting well into the night, Mitch.
Sharnel Vella at State Parliament, thank you. One MP says police are risking a regional spike by waving people through Melbourne's Ring of Steel. Reason Party MP Tanya Maxwell posted these pictures from the checkpoint on the Hume Freeway at Kalkallo. Notorious bikie boss Toby Mitchell is in custody tonight, accused of bashing a man. Tegan Doling is covering developments and Tegan, Mitchell is facing court this evening.
That's right, Mitch. His bail application is currently underway right now and he's here at the Melbourne West Police Station listening in. The Mongols boss was arrested at his South Bank apartment earlier this morning and he was brought in by the Echo Task Force detectives wanted for questioning over a serious assault. Now, the court has just heard that Mitchell was outside a South Yarra cafe last Sunday. There was an argument and it's claimed that Mitchell hit a man at least twice. Now, the victim ended up in hospital with a suspected facial fracture, but he didn't report the attack to police in fear of his life. Now, Mitchell has been charged with four offences, including a fray. And Mitch, it's now up to the magistrate to decide if Toby Mitchell should be released on bail this evening.
Tegan Doling at police headquarters, thank you. Brunswick residents were warned to stay inside for their safety today when a factory went up in flames. It took 50 firefighters almost 4 hours to bring it under control as walls threatened to collapse around them.
Determined firefighters forced their way in to battle the blaze, which started in the Brunswick warehouse around 3:30.
Just wow, like just kind of amazement.
They used the angle grinder again and again to get to nearby properties, and at the house next door, they smashed their way in. Its occupant told 7 News she woke to torches in her bedroom and initially thought it was a home invasion before realising they were firemen. On the other side, Mick Turner has a studio.
There'll be a lot of damage from, I guess, water and smoke.
Burning inside flat-pack furniture for Richmond store Jarty.
They're scared that the building might collapse, that's on fire.
Our main problem is around the structural integrity. There's significant cracking in the walls.
Another issue was water supply. An enormous volume was needed, but pressure in the area is so bad, firefighters asked Yarra Valley Water to pump it up. As thick smoke lingered, locals like the Deladovic family, whose house backs onto it, were warned to stay inside.
I was just wanted to check that the fire wasn't going to spread.
The cause is not yet known. Paul Dowsley, 7 News.
Melbourne parents are paying the most for childcare in the nation, with average fee increases double inflation. But the federal government says it's rejecting calls to boost the childcare subsidy, insisting it's working to put downward pressure on prices.
Just like the children covered by them in centres around Australia...
Well, you're a good climber, aren't you?
Childcare fees are climbing too. The latest data pre-pandemic showing in the year to March, childcare fees rose 4.4%, double the rate of inflation.
Fees continue to increase and have continued to increase.
They were frozen for several months during the height of the pandemic, now resetting.
They're still below the 10-year average for childcare fees.
In the year to March, the average hourly fees rose to $10.50 in Victoria, $10.20 in New South Wales, Queensland $9.15, South Australia $9.40 and WA $10.30, the highest in the ACT, $11.30.
We would like to see the government increase the childcare subsidy by 10% to 15%.
Doing that would encourage more women back to work and into their own businesses.
They'd be growing those businesses and they'd be employing more Australians.
Labor's now promising to increase the subsidy and remove the income test, extending it even to the very rich.
They'll be providing up to $20,000 a year for those earning over $360,000.
The good news, with rents and other overheads down,
what we're likely to see as we come out of COVID-19 hopefully will be very much a stabilisation of costs.
Hopefully putting rises on the slide. Mark Riley, 7 News.
To breaking news now, and one person is dead, another critically hurt and several injured after a building collapse at a campus of Curtin University in Perth. All emergency services are on the scene and there's a rescue operation underway. The Pope has sent a message to the world on George Pell. The pair met for the first time since the Cardinal's conviction was overturned, with the Vatican taking the rare step of making sure it was seen.
A private meeting, publicised to the world. Cardinal Pell warmly welcomed back by Pope Francis after his child sex abuse conviction and acquittal. A reference, believe many, to the 13 months Pell spent behind bars. The 79-year-old returned to Rome almost a fortnight ago, arriving during a financial scandal with allegations one of Pell's enemies sent Vatican money to Australia to influence his trial.
These are things that should be easily traceable. If the Pope wanted to throw fuel on this fire, they couldn't have done a better thing than what they did today.
The high-profile 30-minute reception devoid of any COVID precautions. No masks, no distancing, as the Vatican revealed four Swiss guards in charge of protecting the 83-year-old pontiff are isolating after testing positive. Over the past week, Italy has seen a surge in coronavirus cases, especially in the region around the Vatican. Masks are now mandatory, even outdoors, but officials didn't respond when asked why the Pope isn't wearing one.
People are trying to understand what's going on. Some have surmised that maybe the Pope has already been infected and he's immune now. There are a lot of concerns at the Vatican, but we are dealing with an absolute monarchy.
Whose leader answers to no one. In London, Sarah Greenolch, 7 News.
Donald Trump is back on the election campaign trail barely a week after leaving hospital. The president fronted a packed rally offering to kiss supporters to prove he's now COVID immune.
Sheltering under an umbrella but out of the White House COVID storm into the warm embrace of the Sunshine State. USA. A rally after recovery declaring his virus defeated.
I feel so powerful. I'll walk into that audience. I'll walk in there, I'll kiss everyone in that audience. I'll kiss the guys and the beautiful women and everybody. I'll just give you a big fat kiss.
The campaign kickstart 22 days out. His radical experimental COVID treatment promised to supporters as cases begin to climb.
We are going to take whatever the hell they gave me and we're going to distribute it around to hospitals.
The crowd shoulder to shoulder and many unmasked, having slept overnight to listen to 62 minutes of Trump, re-energised and defiant. A pitch to reopen the state to tourists, refuse lockdowns and save them from his political rivals.
Biden had a bad day and he said, today he's a proud Democrat running for the US Senate.
Seizing on Biden's slip-up.
I'm running as a proud Democrat for the Senate. When I ran as a proud Democrat for Vice President. And I'm running as a proud Democrat for President.
Having overcome the virus, Donald Trump is now in the fight of his political life. He won this state by a narrow margin in 2016. And tonight he's banking on FaceTime with the faithful to help get him over the line again.
So get your friends, get your family, get your neighbours and get out and vote.
In Sanford, Florida, Ashley Mullaney, 7 News.
Former Demon star Jesse Hogan has been fined $8,000 for breaching Western Australia's strict quarantine rules. Hogan's lawyer told the court the 25-year-old fell into a trap of the attractions of a young lady. The Fremantle forward invited the woman over when he was supposed to be self-isolating on return from Queensland. It's been a tough year for Aussie rules, but the code is booming in Queensland in the midst of the AFL finals. Locals are now getting behind the Lions as they play for a place in football history, but there are some with a soft spot for the Cats.
Far from its natural habitat, the 2020 Premiership Cup shines under a perfect Queensland sunrise. The Cape Hillsborough Kangaroos embrace their shiny new friend, although they might have missed the memo when asked to predict this year's premiers.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, it looks like the winner for this year is Geelong.
We never get the cup out of Victoria, and you go to Geelong. Surely it's a Brisbane premiership.
Regardless of who hops away with this year's cup, the footy landscape up north will be forever changed.
It still feels really surreal, you know, to think that we're going to have the Toyota AFL Grand Final right here in Queensland. I wouldn't have thought in a million years.
You walk the streets, you go to the beach, a lot more people start to recognise you.
The Cats desperate to avoid more preliminary final heartache after falling at the penultimate hurdle four times in 7 years.
Internally, there's no thought of this is what we deserve. We need to go out and play our way. My hunger is as strong as ever, and you know, I'm 32 now, and I know my career's at the later stages, and who knows, nothing's given in football.
Andrew McCormack, 7 News.
Tim Watson's here now, and Tim, the Tigers will put the finishing touches on their preliminary final preparations tomorrow.
They will, Mitch. Chief football reporter Mark Stevens is with Richmond on the Gold Coast. And Steve-O, the Tigers are preparing for a hit-and-run trip to Adelaide.
Tim, they are. Tigers had a day off today. They'll crank things up tomorrow. Main session at Metricon Stadium. They fly out on Thursday for a huge clash Friday night with Port Adelaide. Geelong stepped things up today as well. Trying not to get too sentimental about Gary Ablett. And Collingwood held its best and fairest earlier this afternoon. We'll hear the results soon. A crazy year, Tim. B&F's in hubs. I'll be back in sport.
It has been. Thanks, Steve. Also in sport, find out what the Tigers can expect to face from Port Adelaide on Friday night. A death-defying baseball catch. And the Lakers cause a riot. Mitch, all that and a little bit more coming up in sport.
Thank you, Tim. We'll see you then. Next, a family smash-and-grab nightmare. Another shattering blow for a family hair salon already battling in the lockdown and hit by a ram raider for the third time. Also, help track down a man wanted over a deadly CBD confrontation. New South Wales' premier fighting for political survival over a secret affair. And Londoners defying new restrictions bowled up in the face of soaring COVID cases.
Seven News, brought to you by Industry Superfunds.
We're working on something bigger than we've ever done before. It's bigger than this, and this, and even this. We're creating over 200,000 jobs by investing in Australia. That'll help get our super and the economy growing again. And if you're with one of these, you're a big part of it.
Help each other!
Doing this for my family, to show my kids that it's not just Daddy who is tough and strong.
This is very real for us. The reason why we can't sleep with our families in our beds nice and warm is because of people that can do this job.
Doing this for my boys. I'm not just the mum that packs their lunches.
Above your head!
I'm so much more than that.
Who has the strength to go the whole way?
SAS Australia starts Monday 7:30.
Introducing Macca's biggest and best ever loose change menu with more of your favourites. And for a limited time, you can grab a Happy Meal for just $4. A little goes a long way at Macca's.
Battery power by Still. Only from your local Still dealer.
One sign from above.
What
Dolce Viva, the new fragrance, Valentino.
Discover your signature scent.
I am my store.
Fetch movies. Fetch shows. Fetch them all on one simple menu. All your entertainment, easy. Fetch.
When you sign up your electricity and gas to an eligible AGL residential plan, you can get up to $100 in credits. That's $50 on electricity and $50 on gas. Call us on 131 189 or search AGL Energy to join today.
Optus knows family life can be complicated. That's why you can share a massive 250 gigs across four SIMs per month with the Optus Family Plan. It starts with yes.
Homicide Squad detectives are hunting for a 40-year-old man in connection with a fatal fight on King Street on Saturday night. Police want to question Benjamin McCartan over the death of a 46-year-old Carlton man. A woman has already been charged with murder. A Bundoora hair salon is facing an uncertain future after being robbed of tens of thousands of dollars worth of stock. They've been targeted for the third time in 2 years, and it's taking an emotional toll.
It's the last thing a family business needs when it's already shattered by the pandemic. The hair salon has been shut for 10 weeks under Melbourne's Stage 4 restrictions and has lost 90% of its revenue. This morning it was hit by a ram raider for the third time since 2018.
It's really tough for businesses at the moment, and then to come here and see all of this is heartbreaking.
That's just another part of our business that's been destroyed.
The thief struck at 2 a.m. and escaped with hair extensions valued at $80,000. Last year, this ram raid left the family more than $100,000 out of pocket.
2 years been here, three times robbed, and it just gets worse.
After the shop was ram raided a second time, owners installed protective glass and shutters to stop it from happening again, but it didn't work.
It's so upsetting because we thought this would deter them.
The family now feeling even more uncertain about the future.
This is our livelihood, and someone's essentially just, you know, destroying that.
Louisa Cheatley, 7 News.
Overseas now, and Britain is introducing a new alert-based lockdown restriction. Frustrated Londoners have defied lockdown rules with an impromptu game of high street cricket on a day the country recorded 13,000 new virus cases.
I take no pleasure whatsoever in imposing restrictions on these businesses, many of which have gone to great lengths to reopen as safely as possible. Nor do I want to stop people enjoying themselves. But we must act to save lives.
There are more people in hospital with the virus now than there were before the UK's first lockdown in March. And rapper Kanye West has released his first campaign ad in his long-shot bid to become US president.
By turning to faith, we will be the kind of nation, the kind of people God intends us to be.
43-year-old West is only on the official ballot in a handful of states. The Premier of New South Wales is ignoring calls to resign over a shock secret romance with a former MP accused of corruption. Gladys Berejiklian has rejected claims she must have known about her lover's shady business dealings.
Gladys Berejiklian left home determined she's going nowhere. The New South Wales Premier standing firm against pressure to quit over a five-year relationship with disgraced former MP Darryl Maguire.
I trusted someone who didn't deserve to have my trust, and I'm deeply regretful of that.
No one knew about their romance until Ms Berejiklian's bombshell evidence at a corruption hearing yesterday.
It was something that you and Mr Maguire sought to keep private?
Well, it was, right? Yes.
I just thought she showed a lot of strength to deal with that, and to deal with the choices that she's made in her own life.
Their secret relationship continued even after the Premier forced her lover to resign from Parliament in 2018. He's accused of using his office to broker property deals in Western Sydney.
He made me an offer.
All right, well, you stay away, please.
He sent a text message using her nickname, Hawkers, good news. One of my contacts sold a motel for $5.8 million. I had put her in contact, so I should make $5K. She replied, congrats, great news, woohoo.
If I was aware of any wrongdoing, I would have reported it.
Darryl Maguire will give evidence at the corruption hearing tomorrow. A private premier bracing for another day of public humiliation, hoping she still has a job. Mike Amore, 7 News.
Overseas getaways are off the agenda at the moment, so there's a fresh push for Victorians to holiday at home this year. Regional Victoria is off limits for the moment, but we're being urged to start planning summer holidays now. The pitfalls to watch out for are coming up a little later. Jane Bunn's here next. Jane, it was quite a murky Melbourne day, wasn't it?
Mitch, it was. The city had grey sky, but tomorrow should be feeling quite different. Last night, the sky lit up off the coast with a band of thunderstorms just offshore. Meanwhile, in Melbourne, we had a stunning sunset and a warm evening. But a cool change arrived in the early hours, making it drizzly over the Dandenongs this morning. The rest were quite dry but grey, with this low cloud stuck just overhead. So our temperature has been on quite a journey. It was warmer in the early hours of the morning than at any point out there today. Sunshine returned to southern suburbs this afternoon, and we'll all see that tomorrow. I'll have the full outlook after sport, Mitch.
Thank you, Jane. There's a surprising new plan to stamp out smoking. Why anyone wanting to light up could be forced to get a prescription from a pharmacy. Also, Melbourne's fine mess. 19,000 people hit with a penalty, but only a fraction are paying up. See how a hiker scared off a big cat after a terrifying encounter. And the new app designed to protect sporting stars from themselves.
Bring on the fashion.
Bring on the colour.
Bring on the bubble.
Get ready for a spring like no other.
Charging at the end, wins the Everest.
All the big events are all right here on 7.
Oh, beautifully done. As good as it gets. What a defining moment.
And then the history-making grand final. Under lights at the Gabba.
Biggest party of the year.
Come celebrate with us.
It's a spring like no other, and it's all here on 7. Bring it on.
No.
Come on.
That's the one for you.
Oh. There's too many choices. I'm going to filter through these fillies fast. Should she be
rock hard fit and have won her last start? Or have a history of riding winners? Or is it all about a consistent strike rate?
You know you can select all three of us.
Find your perfect match to your form preferences easily with Ned's Filter Form. Take it to the Ned's level.
Years of relentless improvement have led to pioneering Dyson technology, now re-engineered into a bigger format for faster deep cleaning. Only a Dyson works like a Dyson.
Introducing new Gillette Skin Guard, a revolutionary technology to reduce pressure from your shave and reduce irritation on your face. Gillette Skin Guard, clinically proven for sensitive skin.
At First State Super, we're aware our members breathe life into the community. So we invest to do well for them and to help make communities stronger. We'll never change this commitment, but we have changed our name. Aware of the positive impact our members make, the values we share, and aware that superannuation can be a force for good. We are Aware Super.
Shiny, keep the city with the little fucking soul. So I'ma light it up like that.
Retired teachers are being urged to return to work as part of a $250 million plan to hire more than 4,000 extra tutors to help struggling students get up to speed.
Retired teachers, pre-service teachers, casual relief teachers, we want you and our kids need you.
The rollout will begin in term one next year. It's been revealed only a fraction of the tens of thousands of Victorian fines issued for COVID breaches have been paid. The government says no leniency will be shown, but many who've copped a penalty simply can't afford to pay up.
More than 19,000 Victorians have been fined for COVID breaches, but not even 900 have paid them, a compliance rate of less than 5%. But the government and police are persisting.
But if you've been issued with a penalty notice, you've been issued with a fine, then you need to pay the fine and we will come after you.
The total fine revenue is worth almost $28 million. That's an average of more than $181,000 a day. Some lawyers believe young and disadvantaged Victorians are overrepresented.
Over $1,600 is nearly 10 times as much as a child could be charged for any other fine.
Victoria's fines are steeper than those in Singapore and Russia. They've been issued at a higher rate than any other state.
Simply trying to win a gold medal for revenue raising during the pandemic doesn't seem to have served Victoria or Victorians at all well.
Another 64 fines have been issued over the past 24 hours. That includes 17 people fined for not wearing a face mask, among them three males who told police that they'd been at a friend's house to watch a movie. At the current rate, expect only three of the 64 fines to be paid. Cameron Bowe, 7 News.
There's an ambitious push to make cigarettes prescription only. Australian scientists are exploring new ways to drive down smoking rates, eventually calling for a total tobacco ban.
A doctor's script for smokes, a radical measure for radical results, stubbing out cigarettes for good.
I would definitely support prescription-only cigarettes.
It's one of a range of proposals being investigated at a new tobacco research centre at the University of Queensland.
There's a really good argument to restrict access to this product that is causing so much harm.
Scientists looking at ways of slashing supply, with smoking Australia's number one cause of disease and the cause of one in almost seven deaths nationwide. Other proposals include tighter age restrictions, reducing nicotine in cigarettes and limiting the number of tobacco retailers.
It's a bit ridiculous at the moment that we have Australia's most lethal product available at supermarkets.
It's a personal choice. People have the right to make the choice whether they wish to smoke or not.
It's a form of prohibition. Those sort of rules have failed in relation to alcohol and all sorts of other drugs.
2.3 million Australians still smoke daily, just under 15% of the adult population. The federal government hopes to slash that to 10% within the next 5 years. The long-term goal, a total ban on tobacco. Jo Hayes, 7 News.
A hiker has filmed 6 heart-stopping minutes being stalked by a cougar in Utah.
Go away! No! No! Holy, come on, dude. I don't feel like dying today.
He'd stumble across her cubs on his walk and ended up in a terrifying retreat until Mum finally decided he was far enough away and gave up. AFL stars are being armed with a new weapon to help them avoid social media blunders. It's being developed by a former rugby league player who knows the pitfalls only too well.
Todd Carney flourished on the field but struggled off it. In 2014, his infamous bubbler photo was posted online and ended his NRL career.
It spread on social media because that's what happens when something gets on social media. It spreads like wildfire.
Now he's teamed up with best mate Mitch McAuliffe to help today's young players.
He approached us with an idea, making it a bit safer for players to put up a post on social media.
which would give them a buffer with a manager giving approval or declining the post before it uploads.
Helping to avoid headlines like Josh Adokar and Latrell Mitchell's gun charges, Nathan Cleary's COVID breach, and a long list of sex tape scandals.
Anything that allows that kind of reflection and that pause is a good thing.
Something that could also have saved Israel Folau and Rugby Australia millions. While in the AFL, Crows player Riley O'Brien might have escaped embarrassment for publishing his game plan and insults on Twitter.
I owe it to the game to try and teach kids of today.
And this time, Carney could be onto a winner. Tom Saker, 7 News.
Google is under scrutiny over privacy. Next, what you need to know about your internet searches. Also, how Melbourne has rallied to help a stranger doing it tough. A new setback for a major COVID vaccine trial. And your rights if you need to get a holiday booking refund.
It's the massive finals party.
Bruce McAvaney's preparation.
A little bit. That's why he's so good.
Gavin, maybe not so good there. Yep. I reckon someone may have had a little word to Gavin.
And Angus Brayshaw finally comes to pick up his onions.
It's your moment of reaping.
The Front Bar, Thursday, 8:30 on 7.
When you're ready to go back to work, career coaching is there to help work out what's right for you. TAL, ensuring this Australian life.
No.
Come on.
That's the one for you.
Oh, no.
There's too many choices. I'm going to filter through these fillies fast. Should she be
rock hard, fit and have won her last start? Or have a history of riding winners? Or is it all about a consistent strike rate?
You know you can select all three of us.
Find your perfect match to your form preferences easily with Ned's Filter Form. Take it to the Ned's level.
Yeah.
Say yeah to more power with the Amarok V6 and get your first 3 repayments on us.
Volkswagen.
Out there in the universe, stars are born all the time. But not many of them shine as bright as this multi-award winner. Western Star. More than butter.
OMG, what a night. I probably look like...
Shut up! My skin looks amazing!
New Olay Retinol 24 Night Serum. Look how plump and bouncy. Girl, it really works.
We bring you the truth, what inspires and what matters. In this month's issue, Mary and Fred's Summer of Love. We get personal with David Campbell and his family, plus overhaul your health from head to toe. We are the Australian Women's Weekly.
The Australian Government is extending the temporary JobKeeper payment to the end of March 2021. From the 28th of September, businesses must meet the turnover test and submit their declarations by the 14th of each month. There will be 2 new payment rates based on average hours worked, and employee eligibility date changes mean some businesses could claim for more staff. It's part of our plan to keep business in business and Australians in jobs. For more information, visit australia.gov.au. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
A suburban footballer has admitted to a terrifying attack on a nurse in a city laneway, but denies he tried to sexually assault her. Jackson Williams is accused of dragging the woman into an alleyway and putting her in a headlock. He'll find out if a judge believes him later this week. Top lawyers have been brought in for a landmark legal case between the consumer watchdog and Google over users' private details. The ACCC claims the net giant failed to properly obtain consent to monitor other websites their users visit. Google says users were given the opportunity to opt out. The case will return to the federal court later this month. A gold tick could be displayed on Melbourne restaurants taking extra precautions to keep COVID safe. It comes as retailers warn Christmas could look very different if they aren't able to reopen soon.
Abandoned by the state government, strangers saved this Berwick business from collapse.
He bought a pair of socks, and under the socks he left a bundle of money. There it is there, $1,000.
Seven News last night revealed Harry was days from shutting his menswear store. Now the 11th hour supports prompted him to push on, breaking COVID-19 restrictions to reopen.
My business is saved overnight.
But flouting the rules isn't an option for everyone. Those in hospitality are so desperate for the green light, they've launched their own strict health and safety guideline. The gold tick will mean a venue's using a contact tracing app and undergoing antimicrobial and industrial cleaning. 247 venues are now on board.
We don't want to open and do it unsafely. We want to be best in the world.
The alternative is costly, $100,000 for these pods that will transform car parks and open areas into dining hotspots. But they won't save bricks and mortar stores that have now been shut for more than 200 days.
This would normally be the busiest time of the year to hit the shops, with just 10 weeks to go until Christmas. But this year, with no idea when they'll be allowed to reopen, major retailers say they could struggle to meet the Christmas demand.
Now, national retailers are now starting to divert inventory from that was allocated to Victoria to other states which are performing exceptionally well.
Jodie Lee, 7 News.
Johnson & Johnson has halted its COVID vaccine trial after a volunteer became sick. The company says some illness is expected as part of the stage 3 trials. The patient is under review. We're not the only ones spring cleaning during lockdown. The meerkats at Melbourne Zoo are also getting a makeover. Keepers have updated their enclosure, leaving the 20-strong mob to enjoy new rocks, logs and sand. Tim Watson is next with sport. And Tim, a historic Brownlow medal count is taking shape.
That's right, Mitch, and we're going to cross live to Queensland for exclusive details on the big night. Plus, a cat superstar dangerously close to some unwanted history. Why the Power aren't intimidated by Dustin Martin and the Tigers. The NBA champs return home as Lakers fans turn the City of Angels into Sin City. And proof catchers really do win matches.
Your idea of outdoor living is what Trex brings to life. Trex composite decking and railing features all the beauty of timber without all of the work. It's engineered to never rot, splinter or warp and comes with a 25-year warranty. Plus, Trex is made from 95% recycled materials. To learn how to bring the performance and durability of Trex decking to your backyard, visit au.trex.com for more inspiration and next steps.
Make a date with spring. Tab, long may we play.
Imagine a stunning four-bedroom, three-living, two-bathroom, double-storey Metricon home for just $289,900. First 30 buyers only. That's more home for less. That's freedom by Metricon.
It doesn't take much to enjoy the perfect night in. A little effort from you and a Ristorante pizza. Dr. Oetker Ristorante. Pizzeria taste, surprisingly, from your freezer.
You remember I'm picking Bex up from school, right?
The JCR's due Friday, so... Which font should we use?
Are you going to video chat this weekend? Your dad and I'd love to see the kid.
He's in...
But can we go out for an hour?
There's a glass and a half in everyone.
Look at you, no braces and all the internet you can handle.
I wasn't so lucky.
Invis is not your parents' braces. Invis is predictable, less painful,
more comfortable. Invisalign.
Did someone say KFC?
I don't care. I love it.
The Sports Report brought to you by KFC. Get your KFC contact free today.
Welcome back. Geelong will be out to break its preliminary final hoodoo against the Lions in Brisbane on Saturday night, returning to Chief Football Reporter Mark Stevens. And Steve-O, the Cats are also celebrating a milestone.
Well, Tim, they celebrated 100 days exactly in the hub today, a quiet little party. I'm not sure they had a cake, but things are going to get a lot more serious. Jack Stephen ran laps today at Southport. He's coming back from injury, of course. He won't play, not quite ready. I expect Geelong to go in unchanged for the huge clash with the Brisbane Lions. Tom Hawkins will play in a prelim this year. Of course, last year he missed with suspension. He's certainly doing his best to keep a lid on the hype surrounding the Gary Ablett and Patrick Dangerfield fairy tale.
The stakes are obvious, but it's hard not to focus on Patrick Dangerfield and Gary Ablett. Danger's played in four losing preliminary finals. Ablett will hang up the boots if Geelong loses. A grand final so tantalising.
There's so many special stories. I think we'll let people on the outside control that and we'll just control what we can internally, but certainly would make for great viewing.
Hawkins adamant Ablett's farewell tour is not a motivational factor.
We haven't, and Gary would appreciate that we don't talk internally about that. He's his normal bubbly self. He's quite remarkable. You know, I've played with a lot of players that push well into their 30s, but being away from home, having the unique circumstance of being Gary Ablett, it's incredible to see how vibrant he is.
After knocking on the door so often, few would begrudge the Cats another grand final.
Internally, there's no thought of this is what we deserve. We need to go out and play our way and beat a side that's playing on their home deck and is playing as good as anyone.
Mark Stevens, 7 News.
Collingwood's season might be over, but there's still a power of work underway at the Magpies. Tom Brown is with the Pies in Maroochydore. And Tom, you've got an update on the playing future of Jordan Dugowie.
Steve, it's becoming a little bit of a farce with his dad managing him, so I think Dugowie will appoint a formal manager in coming days. There's not a lot of interest at the current asking price of up to $1 million, so one option for Dugowie to explore would be to re-sign with Collingwood until the start of his free agency for another 2 years. I've got some significant news, meantime, on Darcy Moore tonight. I understand Moore's finalised a deal with Collingwood in recent days with up to $850,000 a year. It'll see Moore, in effect, become a Pie for life. Adam Treloar declaring he wants to stay at the Magpies today. There was some tentative interest from the Suns. I also understand the Magpies are open to the possibility, if there's a mutual solution, of looking at a trade for Mason Cox. Not sure any other clubs would be interested at this stage. Team, an update on the historic Brownlow tonight. These are the locations where the players will be physically, right across the country. The Gabba, Metricon, Melbourne, Adelaide, and across at Optus in Perth. It's interesting, Christian Petrarca will be with Lachie Neal up at the Gabba, a host of players, as you can see, at Metricon. And it is COVID, Tim, so it's quite appropriate that Collingwood pre-recorded their Copeland Trophy here on the Sunshine Coast this morning. They'll broadcast that tonight. Taylor Adams, probably the favourite. A number of players left early, including Dugowie, ahead of that award. That'll be broadcast tonight, Tim.
Thanks, Tom. Ollie Wines says the Power aren't intimidated by Richmond and he'd love to go head-to-head with Tigers superstar Dustin Martin in Friday night's prelim final at the Adelaide Oval.
Yeah, for sure. I'd be willing to take that. We're not intimidated at all. We play them once a year and we give our all, and Friday will be no different.
Wine says they know what to expect from the Tigers. They've already beaten them this year and are confident they can do it again. Melbourne Storm is confident Cameron Munster will return from a knee injury in time to play the Canberra Raiders in Friday night's prelim final in Brisbane.
There's nothing wrong with it. He's been training with us. He's a massive weapon of ours, so to have him in the team and fit is really important.
The Raiders' confidence is growing after ending the Roosters' bid for an NRL three-peat. Top trainer Chris Waller remains hopeful. His Australian Racehorse of the Year Nature Strip can turn his form around and claim his first win this season in Saturday's $15 million Everest at Randwick.
3 months ago. Obviously, Nature Strip was a clear favourite, and I admit he's not now, but we know that he's the right type of horse to bounce back.
The Everest and Caulfield Cup Day is live on 7 on Saturday. There were huge hits in the IPL last night. Not even cars were safe as Aaron Finch and his Bangalore teammate AB de Villiers blasted balls out of the stadium. The South Africans smashed an unbeaten 73 off just 33 balls.
So good. This hitting is unbelievable.
Bangalore beat Kolkata by 82 runs. And LeBron James and his NBA championship-winning Lakers have flown home to a hero's reception. But LA fans took celebrations too far, with 76 people arrested and 8 police injured. At least there was some cautious fans, one wearing a plastic bubble to enjoy some COVID-safe celebrations. And we may have seen the catch of the year.
Over is Margot fighting the sun. Margot! Oh, and he crashes over the wall. It's about a 6-foot drop on the other side of that fence. Man, what a play.
Tampa Bay's Manny Margot also hit a home run as Tampa Bay beat the Astros 4-2 to go 2-0 up in the series. Dangerous game that, Mitch. And who's going to win Collingwood's Copeland Trophy tonight, do you think?
I think Taylor Adams. Tom Brown was right there. Taylor Adams or Darcy Moore, maybe.
What about Pendles? Has had a pretty good year too.
He has indeed. Yes, he has.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
I won't leave him out.
No inside information for him?
No, none at all. Thank you very much, Tim. I'm sure. While holidays are currently off limits for Melburnians, we're being encouraged to start planning our next escape. But it comes with a warning to check cancellation policies when booking that well-deserved break.
It's the pitch for us to explore Australia.
A holiday here this year is exactly what this place and all of us needs.
From two Victorians locked at home.
Zoe,
I need a holiday.
Do you?
Yeah, for Australia.
While it's not possible under current restrictions, the push is to get us planning. And these Red Hill Airbnb owners are desperate for bookings. Since March, the luxury barn accommodation has lost 80% of its revenue.
It's been really hard. It's so many cancellations because of uncertainty.
Even with the uncertainty, Airbnb bookings are filling up over summer, with Victorians betting we can at least travel locally. Holiday makers are being urged to consider stays with flexible cancellation policies just in case. Good for the consumer, not so much for the accommodation owners.
It's been very difficult, and now with Grand Final weekend and Cup Day weekend coming up, we're potentially exposed to millions and more dollars of refunds.
Tasmania will reopen its borders on October 26, but Victorians aren't allowed. In what's becoming more of a mess to manage, interstate holidaymakers are still allowed to drive through Victoria to board the Spirit of Tassie. They're just not allowed to stop anywhere except for fuel on their way to the dock.
We won't put Tasmanians at risk.
The wait for the great escape continues.
I think we're doing this.
Georgia Commons Soli, 7 News.
Jane Bunn has the forecast next. Jane, how does it look tomorrow?
Well, Mitch, the spring roller coaster continues. Now we're turning warm and sunny. I'll show you how long that'll last next.
Hello, tonight on the latest from 7 News, we'll go live to that building collapse tragedy at Perth's Curtin University. How did that enormous glass roof collapse? And terrifying encounter. I speak to the hiker who narrowly avoided that big cat attack. That's tonight at 11, the latest from 7 News.
Enter tonight's code word, finals, along with the daily code word from the Herald Sun at 7news.com.au/AFL for your chance to win.
Beautiful clothes deserve maximum protection. Nivea Black and White Anti-Stain Deodorant. Blacks stay black. Whites stay white longer. Now in 3 limited editions by Australian designers. Black and White.
Hey, I've been held up.
Yeah, don't worry.
What have you got there?
The new T-Roc. You'll just want one. Volkswagen.
Guess which fertiliser residential and commercial gardeners use to consistently achieve stunning results in the garden? Charlie Carp, of course. Good for your garden and good for the environment too. Hook on to Charlie Carp. It's good for everything your garden grows.
Is that your dog?
It's the neighbour's dog. Well, my
my insurance cover this?
Budget Direct would have provided you with temporary accommodation for up to a year while they repaired it.
Budget Direct. Insurance solved.
Take more control over your hay fever. Prevent symptoms before they even start.
Try Nutel Nasal Allergy Spray. Its active ingredient binds to receptors in the nasal cavity, preventing congestion, runny noses and sneezing. Try Nutel Nasal.
Can care be better at home?
Someone from Medibank mentioned that there's a chance I can do rehab at home.
I said, oh, how much extra is that going to cost?
And they said, no, you've got it in your hospital cover. It just was fantastic for me.
Let me tell you about Fairy, from the world's number one dish care company. For stuck on grease, just spray Fairy Easy Spray and grease melts away. For hand washing, Fairy Dishwashing Liquid lifts off tough grease before your eyes. And for your dishwasher, Fairy Platinum Plus beats Finish Quantum at cleaning stuck on food on the first wash. Try it like I did. Switch to Fairy, from the world's number one dish care company.
On one hand, using mobile data and internet reduces Australia's carbon footprint by reducing travel and making business more efficient. But their use also creates CO2, and your carbon thumbprint may be something you have never even considered. Well, there is a solution. Belong, carbon neutral, mobile and internet.
I think he did it. He's up to his eyeballs in this murder.
Tell me it isn't true. Tell me he didn't do it.
Did I do it? What evidence does he think he has?
Home and Away, this week on 7.
This weather report is brought to you by Belong, carbon neutral, mobile and internet.
Hello again. Grey cloud lasted all day in the city, but sunshine returned to Geelong and the Mornington Peninsula this afternoon. The cloud and a southerly wind meant that we didn't rise above 16.6 today. It was 20 degrees in the early hours of the morning before the cool change arrived. Northern Victoria had bright sunshine, while grey cloud moved across southern Victoria, breaking up in the west during the afternoon, while Gippsland turned cool and drizzly. There is quite a difference from north to south. A few spots in the south were just 15, while the northwest rose up and over 30. The cloud is from a cold front clipping our coast, while high pressure still controls northern Victoria. The high will strengthen to our east tomorrow, so the warmth of the north should spread back through the south. Our next wet weather comes from a trough, low and cold front that are crossing the Bight. After warmth and sunshine tomorrow, we'll see rain and thunderstorms on Thursday. The cold front pushes out from southwest through to the northeast, then it clears during Friday. But there is more. The low should affect us on the weekend, with wet weather returning on Saturday and slowly clearing on Sunday. This one may be heaviest in the north and east. Around the nation tomorrow, cool and grey in Sydney after a gusty cool change there tonight. A mix of sun and cloud in Brisbane, the slight risk of a morning shower. Adelaide, lots of sunshine jumping up to 31, dry and mild in Perth. To Victoria, the south has early fog and there's drizzly low cloud in the morning in Gippsland. Otherwise, we are mostly sunny. Just a bit of wispy high cloud overhead as warm air spreads back through the south. Now, there is the slight chance of a late storm over in the west. Most are dry, very isolated if they occur. Closer in, there is a foggy low cloud at first, but that quickly clears to a mostly sunny day. Temperatures are jumping up in light northerly winds. Some are 10 degrees warmer than today. The city rises back up to 24. Any foggy low cloud clears by 10 a.m. Then there is lots of warm sunshine and it stays warm at night too, and on Thursday morning and some of the afternoon it'll be a top of 25 on Thursday in gusty northerly winds. But there is the chance of a late thunderstorm in the afternoon and rain at night with a cold change coming in. On Friday, sunny in the morning, bit of cloud in the afternoon. I think it'll stay dry. Some wet weather does return for Saturday, though, and Sunday as well. It could be mainly in eastern suburbs. Then drying up on Monday morning and slowly warming in the sunshine. So we jump up to 24 tomorrow. Lots of sunshine out there. That is once that fog clears in the morning, Mitch.
Thank you very much, Jane. Now, this is what's on Sunrise tomorrow.
Thanks, Mitch. When you wake up, the new iPhone will finally be revealed.
After months of rumours, your first look, that's tomorrow on Sunrise. See you in the morning, Melbourne.
Thanks, Matt and Sam. And that's the way it is this Tuesday, the 13th of October. Thanks for your company. For now, from the 7 News team, good night.